Sometimes clients deal with traumatic memories that play over and over in their head. You're worthless. You'll never be anything. You're stupid. You're not smart. You're fat. You're ugly. Whatever it is, those memories play over and over again in the client's head. And so it reminded me today of something that I said to a client one time. I said, you know, if your parent was special needs, if your parent was a special need parent, would you believe everything they said? Would you believe everything they said? And the answer is no. No, they wouldn't believe everything they said. So then I say, so why are you believing what was said? Because clearly there is some disconnect with the parent who keeps saying these things that are negative to their own child repeatedly. So something is off, something is wrong. I said, it's like a mental illness. So sometimes that helps clients put it into perspective. If they were special needs, then you might respond differently, right? Think about it. Or if you didn't want to use a special needs example, then what about if this were a child telling you all of these negative things? Would you still believe it? Probably not. A 5-year-old? No. You wouldn't, probably. So that's the context that we can think of when we are dealing with this avalanche of negative emotions from something that someone has said. Just an idea. I was talking to a therapist today who I hadn't seen in a while, and we were catching up, and I was telling her that. She said, "Say that again." Yeah, that makes sense. So I just thought I'd share it with you tonight. Hope it helps.